just give it to me. I don't care if you. Oh, I'm gonna say you can write it down. I'm not a fussy. I'm gonna die if somebody who else is.
He's a good writer, so I mean, I can't write his that.
Mm, good. That's what I need, but I get the morning.
Although, what do I care?
Yeah.
Oh, man, I took away that gig at the Vanguard. I was gonna get it. If it wasn't him, it would be some other set. Yeah, Aaron Neal.
I like these with the wintergreen.
I don't know.
Yeah, wintergreen, not peppermint. I like wintergreen. Mm-hmm. Do it. Mm. I'm gonna get me some.
Yeah, it's amazing what
it's hard to find these. Not everybody cares.
I got the little the round, you know, the face.
Oh,
lifesavers.
Yeah.
That's an old one.
Put it in my rather first. Where is it from?
Yeah.
Oh, this
okay.
Is ridiculous.
Turn on the microphone first.
Yeah.
Donated it, so it's now only a million or something like that. But it's months behind schedule.
They run a tight ship here.
I mean, installation of the moon.
And it's still going to be here.
Bucket, do you see a bucket?
And the one who wrote that,
yeah,
I think the one who
wrote
that,
right?
Oh,
yeah,
yeah. Yeah,
yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
The farmers? Oh, you got something nice?
All right, I'm going to use
the farmers.
Okay.
The farmers only. Oh, wow. Oh, it's fun things. Oh, it is. I used to read them. That and Reader's Digest. The game.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for coming to Bird and Beckett. It's Friday, which we've been doing Friday evening jazz here since October of 2020. What? When was it? Hey, Marvin, when did we start this thing? 2002. So that's 21 years. We're now legal. We can drink, but we don't have a license. But it's okay, I don't have a car anymore.
Is the booze in the back?
That's what happens. All right. No more detail on that. Thank you for coming out. So we have this wonderful quartet. Tony Johnson is leading the band tonight. This is Tony back here on the drums. He brings the band in on the fourth Friday of every month. So he kind of alternates between this band and a band called the 230 Jones Street Local 6 Literary Jazz Band. There'll be a test on that. So that band will be here next month. But this month we're lucky because we got the quartet. Next month, I'll say we're lucky because we got the 230 Jones Street Local 6 Literary Jazz Band. The quartet is Bob Kenmotsu on saxophone.
Yeah!
Yeah, Keith Saunders on piano.
Woo!
Eric Markowitz on bass.
Yeah,
all right. And we appreciate your help paying the band. We're kind of try very, very hard to reach a certain standard of compensation for these fine professional musicians. And that's not exactly a tip jar. That's just where you give us the funds to pay them with. We pay them what we promise, regardless of what goes in there, unless more goes in there than we think, in which case we pay them more. All right, so we do what we can here at Bird and Beckett. We do it with your help and a lot of donors in the neighborhood. And Jazz in the Neighborhood has stepped up last month and this month. They're helping us out. A lot of stuff goes on to make this work. So the main thing is the musicians make this work. Here they are. I'll get out of the way. They're going to play two sets. Going to 8 o'clock, there's another show at 8:30. Okay, thanks very much.
Thank you, Eric. We're going to open up the show with a tune by Kenny Burrell, and it's called La Resto. So we're right at it here. Thank you. Thanks, folks. Our next tune is a tune that's written by Cannonball Adderley, and it's a tune called Wabash. Wabash Blues. I remember in the old days, but that wasn't written by Cannonball. This is the Cannonball tune. It's from an album, Cannonball and Coltrane. Okay.
Thank you.
that's a nice tune. I hadn't heard that tune for quite some time. It used to be a long time ago when I heard it first, and then nobody seems to play it.
Well, they should.
They should. You're right. Exactly. Yeah, it's a good tune. Anyway, so I'm going to move right along here, and our next tune is a tune by Wayne Shorter called Black Nile. One, two, It looks like we got another Wayne Shorter tune right now.
Bring it on.
This is called The Big Push by Wayne Shorter.
Thank you.
record for this band. This is Tony Johnson Quartet. Tony there on the drums, ripping that kid into submission here. Yeah, tell you, sometimes you gotta speak sternly to these cymbals. All right, it's all symbolic. Okay, so the Jung is over here behind Keith. You can go there and find that man and his cymbals. All right, Eric, thank you for being here on bass. Bass guitar,
yeah.
literary humor, yeah, yeah. All right, great. So yeah, Keith Saunders on piano up there.
Yeah, all right, Keith.
Bob Kenmotsu on saxophone. And yeah, we alluded to Eric. That would be Eric Markowitz on bass.
Yeah,
and Tony Johnson. So is this band satisfying y'all? You doing all right with this band? So this is what we've come to expect at Bird and Beckett. Many years in, 21 years in on Friday nights. So thank you for helping this music exist by helping us pay the band. All right, you got one more before the break?
Oh, yes, we got.
Sure. At least one more. I think break time pretty soon. Well, you do what you want to do. I can't tell this guy anything. Because he's a professional. Do you tell your doctor what to do? No, he tells you what to do, right? And your doctor, but your doctor works for tips, right? Right. Your plumber works for tips, right? So don't ever rely on that. That bucket there is just to underpin our commitment to paying the bill. So help us out. Donate to the nonprofit. That really helps us out. A lot of people do. We get a little grant support, and we get some support the last couple of months from Jazz in the Neighborhood, which is a very important institution which y'all support. Okay, I think they got more music. Those cymbals doing all right?
We do have more music.
Tell them about it. All right.
All right, you guys. So I'm struggling with the cymbal stand here. Man, it collapsed at the most inopportune time, but that's the way it usually works that way. Okay, so now we've got a tune by John Coltrane.
Oh, good.
And this is a tune called 26-2. Yes, that's right, 26-2. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, thank you, folks. We appreciate it. Bob Kenmotsu on tenor sax. Keith Saunders on piano. Eric Markowitz on bass. My name is Tony Johnson. That's the end of the first set. We shall return. All right. We're here till 8 o'clock, and then we've got another group starting at 8:30, I believe. So, Eric will say more.
I'll say this is the Tony Johnson Quartet. Tony Johnson on drums. Smith Dobson calls him Tony the Tiger, and it's not far from the truth. Yeah, Tony showed up in San Francisco in 1959, and we haven't been able to shake him ever since. He's tenacious. He's the tenacious Tony the Tiger. So let's hear it for Tony one more time. Come around on the fourth Friday of every month. And you'll find him here leading the band. All right, there goes Bob Kenmotsu. Yeah. Eric already split. Keith already split. There he is over on the side. Thank you for being here. Thank you for supporting this music. It's so important. We really appreciate it.
They'll be back.
Mysteries. You know, it's too bad you can't come to my house right in my foyer.
They, people left tons of books, and I don't know which ones to bring you. Do you like anything on, like anything to do with the Tao, the Siddhartha? Okay, any, there's a couple other.
We like mysteries.
I think there's a couple of mysteries, but I would rather.
These seem like a lot of joint, which they're great. I really enjoy it.
Well, any, you guys get together with Sonny, and I got a bunch of CDs that you guys can go through before I take them to good ones. Pick them, they're good ones. Pick them what you guys want. I got tons of stuff. I'm going through the ones I had in my house. Left, and I got
nice
so much good jazz, all this stuff. As I used to tell, I told somebody that she was, says, I'm not a night person. I used to go to the clubs on Fillmore and go home at 6, 7 o'clock in the morning. I am. I love the speakeasies. I'm a hip cat.
The last 30 yards.
Get that from New York, too.
That's true. That's true.
Where were you?
We went to the Haight Ashbury. Social worker, she has a romantic attachment to a guy, and they have a fight. She leaves his apartment, you know, in anger, like that's the end of it. And then she comes back later and she says, I left my file folder here. I'm told, and she's like in psychology, that when you leave something someplace, it means you want to go back there. But I left my purse on the subway once, and I said, no, I do. But she wanted to go back.
Got your book.
I got my books.
Okay. One day I'm going to wear my braces so you can see it. Yeah, but you're going to love it. It's a little bit bigger. Your friend got some green, it's a purple one too.
Yeah.
Really beautiful bracelet.
Well,
I showed you
my lavender jade
necklace.
That one that's on that with my other charms.
Right,
yeah. I worried about it because when I bought it in Thailand, they apparently sometimes try to cheat.
Oh, I know,
like
Jay.
Everybody.
I know it. I studied jewelry.
Yeah.
I know jewelry.
Yeah.
I know.
And
I
what they do is they dye it. And they do something to change the color.
Yep.
And make you think it's
lavender. They dye it. Yeah, they, it's like when they lab dye, like when they do diamonds and stuff, or gems. They make emeralds and rubies redder and greener. Yeah. No.
I wear it all the time.
Yeah.
I mean, I used to wear it all the time. And so it went in the shower with me. It went everywhere with me.
Right.
And it's never changed color. So
I know. It's called Jade. I have a book on Jade.
Yeah.
National Geographic had a book come out one time on Jade.
Yeah.
And
I do like the wintergreen.
Yeah.
Wintergreen lifesavers used to be my favorite too.
That's the ones I have. The wintergreen ones.
Just green leaves.
They're my favorite. Yeah, I like wintergreen too.
I had some things for.
Well, you're going to have to go to Jim and Julie's show with me sometime. You, just for the hell of it.
Yeah. Oh, I love it.
Let's go with me.
When do you...
When it comes up. It's going to come up.
German expressionist.
I get them in the mail.
It's German.
I get the flyer in the mail.
Yeah.
And I want to buy a diamond tester.
Yeah.
See, I have all this antique jewelry that I used to be jewelry... I've had people I dealt with in my life that had jewelry stores and stuff, and some people died and left me all this stuff. And because they know, well, I lost some things too. And then I wanted to find it because I don't know some of the rhinestones. Are they rhinestones or are they be diamonds? And I don't know. Not something
more
and
more.
I know
I've seen this
my
one.
Son has problems with money
there,
and giving.
They had like live.
Yeah, well, it's good for the right person. It's
Yeah, this is the first Thursday.
I guess.
Yeah.
But I give my heart to somebody
who's
greedy or wants to think negative of me later on. But I'm not just a piece because I him, but I'm very genuine, and I like you. I just give it.
Yeah,
I like
the
ring or cake it then. My mom was the same way. My dad's different. My sister. I don't know about my brother, because he's been out of his life for so long. How unfortunate for him. We can have love.
Yeah.
Unfortunate. I still love him. I mean, I can't never tell him because he doesn't want to hurt. What can I do? I'm not a hater.
Yeah.
I can't go through
Vertigo,
life like that.
Well,
I can't have like vengeance like
it just,
that.
Well, it just,
one of the characters
to me, you know, it's...
San Francisco to me, it's disappearing fast.
It's a waste of your life.
Oh, to always have
to
that
back
in my... Oh, I can't talk to this because I don't like them, this, what they did.
Yeah.
Yes. No. You know,
but
if I get that again...
You're wasting your life of joy. You know,
that's how I told my son. I said, I don't hate anybody. I don't like necessarily the
first time ever
I don't like
the
hurt that came with it. But that's my problem. You have to live with what you like to me. I didn't do that to anybody. I didn't make anybody suffer that I know of. I'm not perfect. I probably did a few things, you know, maybe said the wrong stuff wordingly, and then I'm very conscious of what comes out of my mouth and how I say it. Then I go, I'm very sensitive because I don't want to be like, and I have the right hand. Boy, has I my friend, no name mention, wrote an email or a voice text to another our friend, and she says, in the text, she referred to me
he was offensive to women.
Big talker.
I didn't know all this stuff, but he was great. He was a good actor.
Mm-hmm.
And
I called her on it. I said, you know, we've been friends with each other since my son was 4 or 5 years old. So
no,
big talker. What did you mean? I want to hold this thing. Did you see that big talker in that capacity? Miss Know It All? Or big talker that's not, you can't tell me anything? Is that a big talker? I made a mistake. I said, how unfortunate. I didn't know you thought of me like that. You know, I didn't make a big thing up, so I let it go. I recorded her, let it go. We talked about it, let it go. Kind of that way. Sonny and I talk like that, because Sonny and I think we're very dominant women and sometimes. You know, I know that. But I still like her. You know, I still understand. I just don't, I don't like
so much.
Which I noticed in our little gang, they have to be right all the time. No, I don't think so.
Well,
not any more than the other two.
Maybe not.
No,
I've been trying to pull back. Sonny and I had a big sort of a big blowout last year sometime. But where, you know, she just really felt like I was just never accepting anything she said, and that I always put her down. And I noticed that I did do that.
I don't think you do it intentionally.
No, I don't intentionally.
Because let me tell you something. My son and my relationship with someone, he says, I like sending money, she always puts you down.
Yeah.
See? Would she see you, somebody else sees, because the thing about being right all the time, or you said it wrong, or that's not the way.
But see, I tend, that's the way I used to argue, and that's the way I argue, because I would get so frustrated, because I'm sure I was right.
It's okay, but it doesn't matter.
I know it doesn't
matter. You might be right in your world. I'm open like that. But I'm very open to other people's lifestyles. Doesn't mean not to believe that way, but I listen. But one thing I don't feel I have to be. I don't care if somebody wants to be right. What hurts me more is offend me in front of a people I'm talking to. And one time, I think it was, I went to see my son play at the warehouse. And remember, I was talking about the thyroid, and my son was on the other side sleeping, and she yelled out, "Thyroid, that means dual means two." She yelled at me. And I went, and then, you remember my response? I said, I know what dual is. I don't need your input. See, that's what I mean by that. I wasn't talking to you. That was your conversation. You were over there sleeping. I was talking to you. I was very concerned about your thyroid because my friend, my other friend has a thyroid.
Yeah.
Just sick and very bad too. And you're thin. She's chunky.
Yeah. But mine is not my thyroid. It's my parathyroid.
Yeah. I meant para. Yeah. I said dual.
Yeah.
And that's just says para. That means two. And I go, I know what para means.
Yeah.
And I said, before they call it.
But people
mouse.
Do get mixed up. And some people don't even know there is such a thing.
I do. Yes. I knew what you were talking about, but that was what I'm saying. And besides that, besides the medical, it's just that I didn't need that input from the peanut gallery. Thank you. I was talking to you on a personal basis. I was interested in your what's going on with you. And I don't need to be yelled at and put talked to like that in public. And I got a mouth. I'm afraid that's going to say. I hold back and I'm easy going.
But
you push me in.
That's one of the places where I find it. Not only, I mean, I've tried real hard now to try not. I mean, I try when I'm conscious of it, you know, try not to keep getting into, keep arguing about the same thing.
Don't.
To try to be right. But because I know that that's a tendency. But the thing that I what I noticed though, which is really bad, because it's very unconscious. I mean, I'm very unconscious until I happen to hear it coming out of my mouth, is that I can be that way. That, you know, like, "Hey, idiot, how come you don't know that?" It's the tone of voice that I'm
hearing. Well, I have gathered from our foursome, I hear that from Sonny and your sister towards you a lot. I'm in another realm, and I'm listening, and I'm going, Now, we went to that movie, and I'm going to tell you something. I bring that movie up about Freud. The last session was with Freud, right?
Last interview.
I happened to bring up, I said, well, I wonder how Carlo would respond to this movie. Because is it L. S. Lewis? Is it L. S.
C.
I was gonna say C instead of L. C. S. Lewis believes in God, and Freud doesn't. And they go at it, but it is so on point. So I brought up, gee, I wonder how if I went to the movie with Carla, I had mentioned to Sunny, how she would feel if I more or less go for the Freud side, and she goes the C.S. Lewis side. And Sunny defended you. I didn't, it wasn't nothing to defend. She goes, well, Carla's a scientist. She would understand. I said, oh, okay. But science, but that's the whole crux, the scientist thing. Right?
But I personally don't believe that there doesn't have to be a conflict between religion and science.
Well, that's why I wanted you to see the movie. Well, and you know who else? My friend who is, she's a professor in all the city colleges. She's a professor back, she's like a doctor when she, my friend, up in Humboldt County. And I told her about the sponsor that night, Sunny told her the era thing. And she said, you tell her this, she's wrong. And I said, I don't understand what's in the book about Sunny. She's quick with me sometimes. I don't know what it is, but some people have to have somebody to feel superior to, and I don't. I'm not superior to anybody, not even a dog on the street. You know, I'm seeing this. You have to let him go. Yes, it's important that you know what you need. And somebody that knows you.
Well, I mean, the thing is, it kind of depends.
Is that interesting?
You know that? When people
do that, you say that. And to feel
but
you have to have other people. Not saying you. Other people have to make sure they know that you're right.
Well, it's just that I hope that I'm not doing that.
You don't do it to me, never.
But I hope I don't do that because I'm feeling
superior. I never get that from you. I love Sunny. I get it from her. That's why she
hurts
so many
people. You
know.
Very pleased. We got a couple new people who came in from the back. We want you to stand. Keep coming back. Also, there's an 8:30 show. Go get some dinner. Come back for that. So you know what you're in for. Keep being in for it. Thank you so much.
Are we ready to roll here?
Oh my God.
Yeah.
Okay. Second set. Oh, we got. Oh yes, definitely. We need some rowdy people here. Right? Make sure everybody's awake.
No trouble.
Okay.
Look
at that. We got the bouncer in. Straighten things out here.
I've got some wilted celery in the refrigerator.
Okay, we're going to start the set with a tune by Sonny Stitt. It's called The Eternal Triangle. And it's this great Dizzy Gillespie album with Sonny and Sonny Rollins, two Sonnies. and Dizzy. I can't remember the name. Anyway. It's a great album. So this is Eternal Triangle.
Thank you.
Tune, and this is called, this is a tune in 3/4, it's called Clockwise.
Start at letter B, you think, for
education? Yeah, letter B.
Thank you. Okay, so we'll have to shorten the second set a little bit, seeing that I guess we didn't come back on time. Is that the way it works? So, anyway. Oh, anyway, going to do a ballad. Yeah, Love a Man. And then we'll see what we got. And then I think we'll do a Dexter tune, probably to finish up. I Want More. That's what you're supposed to say. I want more.
We all want more.
Thank you.
Okay, so now. Channel. Yeah, take the channel. Yeah, hey. Hey,
Trent.
That's an East Coast thing. Well, it's an old one, yeah, right. Anyway, so we're going to finish up the set with a Dexter Gordon tune. And it's called I Want More.
We want more.
That's right. That's what you're supposed to do. Leave the audience wanting more.
Especially the women.
That's so they can come back again.
Especially us women.
Ah, thank you, folks.
Security!
Bob Kenmotsu on tenor saxophone. Keith Saunders on piano.
Yeah.
Eric Markowitz on bass. Yeah. My name is Tony Johnson. And we shall return.
All right.
And we have another band coming in another half hour. So stay right there. And here's Eric.
So the Tony Johnson Quartet will be back in 2 hours. All right, guys. At the midnight show. All right, so yeah, thank you. One more time for the quartet. Come on, people. Thank you for coming out. We're going to have a quick little turnaround. We're going to let some musicians out and some musicians in, so please be aware of the aisles for us, because this is like a busy little jazz club. All right. So coming up, Brent Ramos with a quintet, going to add a guitar to the instrumentation up here. So that's happening in a minute. Okay, thanks, Tony.
Yeah,
thank you all. Thank you all. Thanks to Tom back there on the sound. I hope it sounded good out there. It will also sound good on the internet. Yeah. Okay. Thanks.
I thought it was 9 years. For about 9 years.
So you had to. All right, last.